positive identification of the traitor's cruiser, linking to your tactical display.
Follow my intercept course. Take us around the fiercest fighting and deliver us near his flank.
Target shows no sign of evasion. General, forward weapons locked and ready.
Fire!
Your shield is down. Forward disruptors. Recharged and locked.
Hold fire. Lower shields.
General, they are beaten. I request the honor of delivering the final death stroke.
Maintain your position aft of their rear shield array until you hear from me directly. I will now bring an end to this charade. Chief Engineer, transport me to the traitor's bridge.
I care nothing for the damage to the engines. I want Chang! Shake him off and bring us back, or your head will adorn my...
Kalnor, son of Gior, I challenge you under the ancient rites of blood peace. Your officers will bear witness.
Chang, this is not one of your lectures at the Academy. This is a warship of the House of Gior. Your life became my property the moment you beamed aboard. There will be no duel.
Our ancestors settled their differences in this fashion. The rite of blood peace may have fallen out of favor in this decadent age, but it is no less binding today. Or will you flaunt your cowardice in the very presence of your men?
You are a fool, Chang. Chancellor Lorak will fall. His illness weakens him by the hour. Already he is unfit to lead the High Council. Withdraw this challenge. Join me, and I will ensure a proper place for you within my new government.
You cannot avoid my challenge, Kalnor. If it is Lorak's fate to be deposed, so be it. I will ensure his successor will be a man of honor, not a cowardly son of Gior.
Where are your famous words of Shakespeare now, Chang? Had you accepted my offer, you would have lived to fight your true enemy. Now you're just a glob fly on the road to my ascension.
Poor player. Life's but a walking shadow. It's a tale told by an idiot. Sound and fury, signifying nothing.
This day has arrived. So many years of training, study, and instruction. Now I, Torlek, son of Rokva, have earned a place in this hall. The honor to my family name alone was worth the struggle. But what will the general think? Will he recognize that I possess the strength to lead my fellow warriors into battle? Will he? He's here.
I officially welcome you to the Klingon Defense Forces Elite Command Academy. You have surpassed your peers to earn a place within this distinguished hall. But I tell you, this is not enough. In the days to come, you will be tested well beyond your current limitations. Most of you will fail, and failure will mean your immediate dismissal from this institution. Past achievements mean nothing here. I am not interested in the names of your fathers, nor of your family's lineage. What I am interested in is your breaking point. How will you conduct yourselves in battle? How far will you go to preserve your honor and fulfill your duty? These are simple questions that will decide the fate of our empire. One day there will be a war with our true enemy, the Federation. There are those who disagree, but it will happen. Before that day arrives, your role within this great conflict must be determined. This academy was conceived to create the very finest warship commanders in the galaxy. Those few of you who succeed will be granted immediate command of a warship. For those who do not, there will be no disgrace. Whatever becomes of you, either at this academy or beyond, never forget, you are all Klingon warriors. Klingon warriors. I have placed a challenge before you. Let us conclude this address and begin the trials.
Torek, son of Rovak. Your performance in this latest trial has left me with no choice but to dismiss you from this academy. A post will be found for you that suitably reflects your level of competence. Dismissed!
What a fine collection of warriors. So eager for battle. Are you prepared to destroy your enemy?
Really? Today, you will fire the first shots in a campaign that will lead to the destruction of the Federation. This campaign is not real, but I assure you, it will be worse than real. If you can defeat them in my simulated trials, you will be able to defeat them anywhere, at any time. I believe you know when an enemy intends you harm, but are you truly prepared? Have you meticulously observed your enemy? Have you discerned his weaknesses, appraised his strengths, discovered his greatest hopes and fears? To know your enemy is to defeat him before you have faced him. Do not wait until you meet in the coldness of space, for space is the harshest instructor. In any future conflict, the Federation expects a coordinated assault by the Klingon and Romulan empires. They expect us to seize territory along the border, then entrench ourselves for a protracted conflict. Therefore, we will do no such thing. We will begin by creating a breach in the infamous neutral zone. Your task, as part of the Gorcha Group 1, will be to pave the way for our heavy strike forces. Over the years, Starfleet has installed powerful sensor probe nets along their side of the neutral zone to monitor our movements. While a cloaked vessel is extremely difficult to detect under normal conditions, it can be traced at short range by a sufficiently powerful probe net. We must destroy their probe nets without alerting Starfleet before our strike groups can cross the neutral zone. Jamming cruisers will be positioned along the probe net in the Targa sector. Once these are in place and all communications jammed, you will destroy the sensor probes and their monitoring stations. Now, make your approach. Under cloak, the element of surprise must be maintained. Good hunting.
You have all known since childhood the symbol of our empire. It has been called many names throughout the ages. Perhaps the least understood is the Heart of Virtue, or Tik Gop in the ancient tongue.
The Heart of Virtue originated from an archaic weapon favored by Kalas, the Unforgettable. It is said he chose this as the symbol of his house and later the Empire because of the weapon's unequaled balance. Yet this is inaccurate. Kaelas chose it because each of the three blades represents those virtues that are the very foundation of every true warrior. Honor, loyalty, and duty, each in perfect balance. Of these three, duty is the first virtue. It is the beginning and the end of the warrior's path. Without duty, a warrior becomes the slave of vainglory and reckless self-interest. No true warrior could ever tolerate these vices, neither in his comrades nor in himself. With the loss of their sensor probe net, we can now destroy Federation bases and outposts, rendering them incapable of mounting an immediate counterstrike. Surprise is crucial. Starfleet must not learn of the forthcoming assault on their bases until it is too late. We will continue to use our jamming cruisers to stifle their cries for help, but it is your task to destroy any vessel that can warn Starfleet. Should you encounter superior enemy forces, do not engage them alone, but call in assistance from any nearby commanders. I will tolerate no glory-seeking that jeopardizes our initiative. Remember this. Glory is like a circle in the water, which never ceases to enlarge itself, till by broad spreading it disperses to naught. A true warrior never seeks glory. Glory always finds him. Kapla.
Spared me a failure that would have meant my dismissal from this academy. Our paths have never crossed before, friend, but I owe you a debt of honor, and I will repay it. The Eodoch will be satisfied.
Why has the general summoned me? Have I failed in some way? Or could this be regarding something else?
In summary, your performance demonstrated sound judgment in the heat of battle. I have decided to place you in command of a squadron. Your specific assignment will be provided to you.
Thank you, General. I will prove myself worthy of this honor.
See that you do. Are there any questions?
I have no questions, General.
Very well, then. One more thing, Torek. Commander Thochmak and I see a great potential in you. Dismissed.
Yes, sir. Regarding Starfleet, you have said that they lack the warrior spirit. I trust you, General, but how does this explain James T. Kirk?
Ah, yes, Kirk. Indisputably a superb warrior, even honorable. In a limited human sense. It is a little known fact, however, that Kirk is a Klingon.
Sir?
Our people have traveled the stars far longer than humans. Early in Earth's history, some misfortunate Klingon became stranded there and mated with the local denizens. This chance interbreeding produced James T. Kirk many generations later. This is the only acceptable explanation as to why he is such an outstanding warrior. Jests aside, Torek, at one time humans had a warrior tradition, primitive by our standards, but full of promise. They have since turned from it. He is nothing more than an aberration amongst a people that has betrayed its heritage. They are nothing like you and I. Kirk aside, they're not true warriors. I trust this answers your question?
Yes, sir, it does.
Very well, then. One more thing, Torek. Commander Thochmak and I see a great potential in you. Dismissed. So this is the answer. Polish the blade of duty. Sharpen its edge till there is nothing it cannot pierce. But do not be lulled into believing this is enough. The longest blade of the heart of virtue belongs to honor. It is the most difficult to master. It has been said, mine honor is my life, In that I live, and for that I will die. What is honor? Honor is the absolute and unselfish adherence to all virtues, to truth, to courage, to forthrightness. It encompasses all these, and yet it is greater. It is the fire illuminating the differences between an armed savage and a true warrior. It is the light that will guide you along the warrior's path. We have secured a breach within Starfleet's layered defense network. They do not yet realize the extent of their losses or the disposition of our forces. They will therefore seek to draw us into large engagements in the hopes of slowing expansion of this breach, but we will not allow this. Our true objective lies deep in Federation space, and the bulk of our fleets will proceed under cloak to the staging area. I have separated you into four squadrons, each comprising three birds of prey. Your task will be to assure the Federation that our intentions are to expand our immediate borders. You must strike swiftly and render the illusion of being two places at once. Engage targets of opportunity, but avoid heavily defended ones. Call in support from nearby strike groups as needed. If successful, Starfleet will believe that we are committing the bulk of our forces to sectors along the neutral zone. Individual assignments will be delivered once the trial has begun. That is all. Kapla.
Just when you thought this mission would prove your undoing, I have arrived to ensure your success.
Zhajek, what are you doing here?
The general decided that my glory-seeking deserved a demotion to a bird of prey. But I have turned it to my favor by requesting I be assigned under your command. This way, I will continue my academy term and repay my debt of honor to you. Am I not a genius?
Zhajek, I accept your debt to me, but I will also not tolerate any glory-seeking or disobedience. Do you understand me?
Understood. I will do nothing to jeopardize the mission or your command. Chuvan out.
Look around this great hall. What do you see? Many of your peers are gone. Yet you remain. That is as it should be. The weak must fall to give place to the strong. But do not allow yourselves to grow callous. Security is mortal's chiefest enemy. All true warriors travel the same river of blood. If one is disgraced, we are all disgraced. If one finds his death in glory, we all share in that glory. No true warrior would allow another to suffer an unjust disgrace, nor would begrudge him the fruits of a well-earned victory. Know this, and your mastery of the heart of virtue will be all but complete. Ignore it. You will ultimately fail yourselves as you fail your comrades. That is why the final blade of the heart of virtue signifies loyalty, because we are all united by our common journey. I commend you on your performance thus far. As expected, Starfleet has rewarded our efforts with a significant military response intended to contain our forces along the neutral zone. This betrays their belief that our objective is to seize new territory along the border. To nurture this belief, the lightning strikes must continue. Make the enemy believe our forces in the immediate area are far more numerous. Yet beware, with their reinforcements, we are likely to encounter more heavily defended targets. Do not be tempted to engage them. Report them to the nearest heavy strike group. Remember, you are the spearhead of a deception that will ultimately bring ruin to the Federation. Go now. Do not fail.
Academy instruction has been suspended for several days in observance of the Kopaval Festival. I finally have time to see my father. And yet the general summons me in the middle of the celebration. Why the urgency? And secrecy?
Tolek! I have summoned you for a very special purpose. Before I continue, I must have your full support and pledge of silence.
You have it completely, General.
Good. I am certain you are familiar with the recent attempt to overthrow Chancellor Lorak and the rumors of the Chancellor's weakening health.
Yes, General. I doubt there is any corner of the Empire where word of this has not spread.
I can now confirm these rumors are true. I thought the threat posed by the House of Geoch had ended, but I was wrong. Kalnor left behind a half-brother named Melkor. My sources inform me this Melkor is building support for a second attempt to overthrow Lorak's regime. I have a time and place for a meeting between Melkor and the heads of four other houses. You see why I have summoned you.
Yes, sir. I believe I do.
I have acquired an experimental bird of prey that carries an extremely sensitive passive sensor array. It will allow you to eavesdrop on Melkor's meeting. Take command of this vessel. Warp while cloaked to the Krios system and locate Melkor's flagship. You must maneuver within 50 meters of his bridge and come to a full stop. At that range, you will be able to engage the sensor array and monitor the meeting. Before you depart, have you any questions regarding this mission?
None, sir.
And I wish you good fortune, Tolek, son of Rovak. Kafla.
I am greatly honored to be chosen for this special assignment, General. Yet, why have you chosen me, a student, and not one of your seasoned commanders?
My associates and I are being watched closely by allies of the House of Geoch. We cannot conduct this operation without attracting notice. And I am forced to turn to someone not directly linked to me. After examining your records, I have concluded you are the only one I can reasonably trust to succeed. I regret sending one of my students in what should be my place. But the situation demands it. The Empire will be ruined if the House of Geoch fulfills their honorless ambitions. What I ask of you has nothing to do with your studies here. Yet it is vital to the future of our Empire. I wish you good fortune, Tolek, son of Rohan. Kapla!
I have sworn to you. I and my house stand ready to support your claims. But we must know the exact nature of your plans before we declare ourselves publicly.
I do not want you to declare yourselves publicly. At the proper time, I will reveal everything. Until then, you will wait patiently.
Wait! Lorak is at his weakest now! The time to strike is now!
I will ascend and take my rightful place as leader of the Klingon people. It is my destiny, but it will happen in a fashion of my own choosing. You may follow me and share in the glory to come, or not. The choice is yours. But if you will follow, you will obey.
Destroyed!
You fear the risks. I will waste no more words and count you amongst my enemies. Good, now leave. You may beam directly out of these chambers. I will contact each of you in the weeks to come.
No sooner have I returned from the Krios system than I find myself once more before the General.
Tolek, congratulations on a mission well done. You have justified my confidence in you.
Thank you, General.
I have reviewed the coded report you sent. The data you acquired will prove vital in the days to come. It pleases me to inform you that you are being promoted. You will begin attending strike fleet briefings and report to Instructor Poktal, commander of the Sukhvart. You will be given command of a light cruiser. Before I dismiss you, you have any questions?
I have no questions, General.
You are dismissed.
Sir, when do you anticipate Melkor will move against the Chancellor?
Well, that is difficult to say. If he waits until Lorak dies, the High Council would waste no time naming a successor. Melkor must strike now while there is still uncertainty, not after. In any event, you have a new command to familiarize yourself with. Dismissed.
General, I mean no disrespect by this, sir, but I have often wondered why you quote the words of this Shakespeare, a human poet. This has caused me some confusion.
Yes, I can see how that may seem perplexing. However, this is not such a mystery. Remember my first lesson to you? Know thy enemy. I have spent the latter half of my life studying human culture and their history. I encountered this Shakespeare early in these studies. He was one of their greatest warrior poets, eloquently writing about the same virtues that we strive for. Pity he was born to a people who cannot adequately appreciate the meaning of his work. He would have made such a fine Klingon. In any event, you have a new command to familiarize yourself with. Dismissed.
Which brings me to the subject of the field of death. It is the place where battle is waged. It may be a high mountain crag or the rim of a black hole. What is important is that you master this place as surely as you do your enemy. If swift attack is called for, what terrain hastens you and hinders your enemy? If you stand outnumbered, where can you position yourself to exact the highest cost from your opponent? The warrior who turns his immediate environment to his advantage has mastered the field of death. He becomes unassailable while rendering his opponent powerless. This is why the Codex of Voxum states that for the master warrior, the ground will gobble up his enemies and the air will strangle his foes. Now I ask you, where is the enemy? Are you lords of the field? If not, why cease you till you are so? While Starfleet commits significant numbers to this area, the bulk of our fleets proceed under cloak to staging areas deep within their territory. We have now reached an operational phase where we must secure forward supply bases within Federation space. To do this, we will use mobile supply bases that can be transported in modular pieces. The Sukhvault strike fleet will escort one of these bases to a secret location. I caution you, however, these modules cannot be transported at high warp speed, and they cannot be cloaked. You must use all your cunning to ensure that this base reaches its destination safely. Now go, and do not fail. Kapla.
Wake up, you worthless Totsuk Jai! Starfleet is employing a new tactic for hunting our warships. Civilian science stations are coordinating powerful long-range sensor sweeps. This hinders any movement through the sector. Two careless squadrons have been lost because of this, and there is no time to wait for additional support. We must destroy these stations before we can escort the mobile base. Cadet Tolik, you, Cadets Jarjek and Kempek, will proceed to the Petra system, where a Federation scout is maintaining its portion of the sensor net. I want the scout destroyed immediately! When you have done this, proceed to the Janus system and regroup with the task force. The rest of you mindless, muck-sucking humans, follow me to our next objective. Go!
I ask you now, what three things make the Federation a powerful adversary?
General, it is their vast natural resources, their economic capacity, and the skills of their science.
Good. Why? The answer lies in their political acumen. They have successfully knitted together countless worlds of diverse races, plundered their resources, assimilated their technologies, and absorbed their wealth. This is their strength, and it is also their greatest weakness. Their size is difficult to defend. Their resources are scattered by time and space. Their political system is unwieldy. These races were brought into Federation not naturally through conquest, but through diplomacy. This last is the key, for it renders the Federation a brittle unity, a unity we will shatter in the days to come. It is war's prize to take all advantages. With the successful deployment of our mobile bases, we are free to strike deep into Federation territory. Before you is a tactical display of Andorian space. You are free to strike any important targets of opportunity.
I restrain you in only one way. Do not attack any human targets other than Starfleet warships. The Andorians will think these strikes are a preliminary staging for our conquest of their space. Let them think this. It will cause a political backlash that will force Starfleet to garrison an area that has no strategic value. This, in addition to the resources they have distributed along the neutral zone, will leave the Federation thinly spread. Be bloody, bold, and resolute. For each new battle, new widows howl, and new orphans cry. Make them wail at the first sign of their own blood. Answer this. What weapons are available aboard a light cruiser?
General, the Cajos light cruiser has a full complement of disruptor cannons along its forward arc.
Wrong. I ask you what weapons the vessel has, and you recite its design specifications. Is this an academy for warriors or an engineering college? Aboard a warship, everything is a weapon. Its tractor beams can pummel an enemy with debris, its transporters can deliver blows that cripple. Those who master this principle succeed in battle. Those who do not die a glorious, but ultimately useless, death. Intelligence reports the Andorians have lodged formal complaints with the Federation Council, citing Starfleet's failure to ensure the safety of the Andorian Republic. Those of you who have studied Andorian culture now see this is exactly how they would turn, given their contentious nature. The situation has prompted a meeting between high-level Starfleet officials and the Andorian ambassador, Magia. Anticipating this, our scouts have trailed him for some time. He is being escorted by a single heavy battlecruiser, and we have his location. The Sukhvalt strike fleet will intercept the ambassador, destroy his escort, board his ship, capture him, and bring him back safely for interrogation. That is all. Kapla. You have come to understand the meaning of the three virtues and how they may be applied. But understanding does not equate to mastery. True mastery can only be achieved with perfect balance. Therein lies the challenge and mystery of the heart of virtue. Any warrior deficient in one aspect is ultimately doomed to fail. Therefore, ask yourselves, is your honor perfect? Are you unerring in your duty? Is your loyalty beyond reproach? Every warrior's life is the Empire's, but every warrior's soul is his own. This balance is a quest that may require a lifetime to fulfill. It is not a lesson that can be taught. It is something you must discover for yourselves as you travel the River of Blood. As a result of our successful acquisition of Ambassador Magia, the Andorians are now clamoring for Starfleet to secure their territory. However, a situation has arisen along the Klingon-Tholian border. In response to our brief incursion into their space, the Tholians have reacted aggressively. Tholian warships have been reported crossing into our territory, destroying several reserve cruisers and key observation outposts. The situation at present is volatile. We cannot afford a second front with the Tholians. Therefore, I am ordering the Sukhvalt strike fleet to intercept any Tholian forces that have crossed our borders, ascertain their objectives, and at all costs reduce the tensions. I repeat, under no circumstances must the situation be allowed to escalate. You must do whatever is necessary to defuse this situation.
Torlek, what has happened?
Colonel, I have encountered the Tholian strike group.
For this, you left your assigned system? Why did you not transmit a coded report?
I have found a solution to this crisis with the Tholians.
Solution?
Colonel, Tholian warships emerging from warp. They have armed their weapons.
What?
We are trapped in an energy web.
By the what? Raise shields. Divert all remaining power to impulse engines. What is the meaning of this?
I have brought the Tholians here, Colonel. They seek you for the death of their assembly member. And once they have you, they will completely withdraw from Klingon space. I'm afraid Chang's orders were explicit, sir. He instructed us to defuse this situation at all costs.
Petokchai! You Nokchai sucking Tukuk! You betray me to these honorless rocks! I will tear out your eyes and feed them to your siblings!
It is over. I am being dismissed. I know it. I have failed the trial. Yet I do not see how it could have been honorably avoided. How will my father accept such dishonor from his firstborn son? How will I live with this failure?
We are forced to divert a quarter of our forces because you chose to disobey your orders. Since you clearly have no sense of duty, perhaps you could better serve the Federation's Starfleet. Should I contact them and give them a sterling recommendation? Answer me!
It is over. I am being dismissed, I know it. How can I live with this dishonor?
This is puzzling me. Are you truly Klingon? Or are you perhaps a human sent here to learn how real warriors train? You surrendered your own commander to the Tholians. Where is your honor? Answer me!
General, there is nothing for me to say. I have failed you, and I have failed myself.
After much consideration, I have decided not to dismiss you. Your past accomplishments speak in your favor, and you may yet prove salvageable. As punishment, however, I am transferring you to Brigadier Kmok's heavy assault fleet. He has no patience for fools. Now get out of my sight.
I do not accept blame for this, General. There was no honorable way to carry out your orders. This mission was rigged for failure.
This mission was, in fact, a unique trial. It was designed to place your honor and duty in direct conflict, to determine which you would sacrifice first. In battle, Torlek, a warrior's values fall into conflict more often than he would care to admit. We test you to prepare for the day you face such a conflict.
Am I the only one tested like this?
No, every Academy student undergoes such a trial. When Colonel Pakhtal was a student here, he also felt this trial was suspect. He was so enraged when I berated him that he drew his dagger and challenged me on the spot. I laughed in his face. That stopped him cold.
Then I am not dismissed from the Academy?
No one is dismissed for failing this trial. But had you not challenged the injustice of your situation, I would have let you believe you had failed. Either way, you would never forget the lesson. I have transferred you to the Roptok Heavy Assault Fleet under Instructor Kmok. He has heard good things of you and is looking forward to your joining his command. That'll be all, Torek. There is one mastery we have not spoken of. And that is the mastery of fear. Fear is true power. Not warships, not disruptors, nor any number of weapons. Fear frames disorder, and disorder wounds. To master your enemy's fear is to make him your slave. In his heart, a warrior must first fight a battle against fear. In this inner battlefield, he either crumbles or emerges triumphant. None can avoid this challenge. Every great Klingon warrior was a master of fear. Ambassador McGeer has been most generous to us. He has confirmed there is a growing schism between the Federation and its non-human members. He tells us of a second Babel conference between certain non-human Federation worlds in the Solidac system. The intent is to discuss their mutual security. The Andorian stance is that if Starfleet cannot adequately protect them, they will sign an independent alliance with the Gorn, rendering themselves a neutral party within the conflict. Starfleet will doubtlessly provide a show of force at the meeting, if only to allay fears, but we will also make a show of force. The brunt of the Roptok heavy assault fleet will strike the moment the conference opens. Your orders are to destroy all Starfleet vessels in the area and strip the planet of its defenses, yet leave the conference untouched. A the height of their fear. We will drive them to panic.
What a perfect day for Starfleet's finest to die. I only regret they cannot appreciate the glorious death we bring them. Cadet Torlik, you will lead Jajek, Kempek, and Kaporik from there to the Mentrax system and destroy all Federation forces encountered. Remaining squadrons will strike surrounding systems. Once these attacks are completed, regroup at the Solidex system for an assault on the Babel Conference itself. Above all, stay alert and calm. I have sworn our complete success to the General, and I have every confidence each of you will perform your duty flawlessly. Now, engage cloaking devices and proceed to your designated targets. Timok, out.
Graduation is within sight, as is the culmination of our campaign against the Federation. This mission will serve as a capstone to everything I've taught you. You have learned the five principles of the true warrior and know how to apply them. As there is sense in truth and truth in virtue, I tell you that you possess the tools to force success from any situation. The lesson you must take with you into this trial is that victory is always possible, no matter the circumstances. The fog of war may obscure it, but it's always there. With our recent success at the Babel Conference, the Federation must now provide protection for all its non-human worlds near the neutral zone. They are spread very thinly. We are now free to hunt our true objective, while they prepare a counteroffensive for what they believe to be our supply lines near the neutral zone. There is one concern, however, that must be addressed. Starfleet operates a military shipyard which is used as a nexus for rapidly recommissioning old warships. It is heavily defended by a Federation battle station. Normally, an entire heavy assault fleet is required to destroy a battle station, but none are presently available. You will destroy the battle station, the planetary shipyards, and all enemy warships you encounter. In my experience, this has never been done before. Yet you must find a way.
Cadets, we will begin by destroying enemy forces in the surrounding vicinity of the Federation shipyards. Once this is accomplished, we will attack the shipyard and battle station. But the plan for the assault on the battle station must first be decided. This mission is the milestone test of your skills in strategic planning. Therefore, the General and I have agreed to leave this decision in your hands. Timok, out.
Sir, we are being hailed by the Kopong, Pochok, and Jeput. Cadets Jajek, Kempek, and Kaporik are requesting a four-way conference.
On screen.
He is full of Sark dung. That station's assault phasers will split us like a gutted targ. Chang is blind in both eyes if he is serious about this.
Bah! Your wailing sickens me, Kaporik. We have the advantage of surprise. I say we approach under cloak to close range, then unleash overloaded weapons. This should collapse their shield. If we are swift and effective with our cloaks, we can sustain attack waves until the station is destroyed.
Then you are as blind as Chang, Jajek.
My vision is more than adequate to place you within my gun sights.
Then come about and face me, Takek Jai. I will even be kind enough to notify you when I fire, in case you cannot see.
Enough! Chang said there is always a path to victory. There must be a way to succeed.
Are you so certain? This would not be the first time the General has placed us in such a situation. I do not see how we can collapse one of the station shields without losing most of our warships. Then why are you here, Kempek? Have you no taste for battle? Perhaps you would prefer that we politely ask the battle station to lower its shields.
Perhaps we should.
What?
We must destroy Starfleet warships in the immediate area, correct? Why not capture one? We make the captured vessel send a distress call, informing the battle station they carry wounded and must dock. When it moves in, our boarding parties trigger a self-destruct sequence.
The resulting explosion should disable the station's shields, leaving us at full strength for the attack. And I thought the Academy did not accept Romulan students. Very clever, but it will not work. The station would never allow the ship to dock, not even for wounded.
This plan is even more stupid than Zhajek's. I am tired of this. Torlek, you make the decision.
Yes, Torlek. You have led us to victory in the past. Do so again, if only to silence Kaporek.
Another secret meeting with the General. I can only hope the situation has not grown worse.
Torlek, the information you acquired was very useful. But there are still many uncertainties regarding Melkor's plans. I have summoned you because there will be another meeting, this time in the Taharak system. As before, I will need you there to observe. Understand, it is imperative we learn Melkor's plans if we are to stop him before he plunges the Empire into another wasteful war. Your transport leaves within the hour. Kapla.
This has continued long enough, Melkor. You must reveal your plans to us now.
There is no need for you to wail like a stuck quarreling. I'm now ready to reveal everything to you, including the additional support I've secured from outside the Empire. But first, there is a small matter to be taken care of.
Dochmas!
Have you detected any surges in neutrino emissions?
Yes, sir. We are ready to execute your orders.
Do so. During our last meeting, my previous science officer detected a strange surge in neutrino emissions. Research revealed there was a spy hovering close to this vessel, monitoring our meeting. The science officer discovered this far too late to catch the spy. But his replacement has performed his duties quite well.
Would you not agree?
I scarcely made it back. I can only guess how the General will receive my failure.
Torlek, it pleases me that you've returned safely.
General, I regret that I failed to retrieve the information you sought.
Think of it no further. Neither one of us could have foreseen Melkor's knowledge of this operation, nor the trap he set. Still, it angers me that we must squander our resources, thwarting the ambition of fools, when our true enemy grows stronger by the day. In just a few hours, you will undertake your final Academy trial. For this mission, I have transferred you to my planetary assault fleet. Before I let you go, have you any questions?
None, sir.
Dismissed.
General, would it not be more sensible to replace Lorak now, before Melkor openly challenges him?
The Chancellorship is not an office to be seized by just any fool with enough political backing from powerful houses. Despite his illness, Chancellor Lorak continues to lead the Empire effectively, as he has for the past 30 years. Lorak was my mentor. Much of what I am as a warrior, I owe to him. While his mind and strength of will remain unbroken, I will not turn my back on him.
Forgive me, sir, but my understanding of the Federation is still not perfect. You have told us they are the true enemy, but why are they our greatest threat?
The Federation represents the antithesis of everything we believe. Klingon values demand that the strong dominate. The Federation seeks to protect and nurture the weak. To us, honor is the principle by which we live and die. To them, it is a loosely formed idea to which they give lip service. Yet it is not their so-called values that make them our greatest threat. It is their institutionalized policies of subversion. Tell me, do you look forward to the day when the true meaning of being a warrior is forever lost?
Of course not, General.
The Federation does. They have successfully subverted the cultures of every society with whom they coexist. If we expose ourselves to their influence, they will corrupt us from within, just as they have done all the others.
This will be my last address. It marks the end of the Academy's term and your graduating mission. Whether you fail or succeed in this last trial, I again urge you to remember, you are all Klingons.
carry a legacy in your blood that lends strength to your deeds, strikes terror in the hearts of your enemies. The hope of every Klingon is to die in the service of the Empire. There is no dishonor in falling before a superior foe. If your heart is pure, your actions forthright, what you have been taught will serve you throughout all your battles to come, till one day you earn an honorable and glorious death. Today we strike at the heart of our enemy. With the success of the Roptok assault fleet at the Federation shipyards, all the pieces are in place. While Starfleet's counteroffensive approaches our fictitious supply lines, we are positioned for a massive coordinated attack against the Sol system itself. My personal assault fleet will engage Earth's home guard and pin them down. The Kornos planetary assault fleet will focus upon all bases in system. Individual strike groups will destroy the shipyards on Mars, research facilities near the Jovian moons, and any other targets of opportunity. It is vitally important that you pin down all of Earth's defenders. It has been a long road that has carried us to Earth's doorstep. We will now show our goodwill by returning to the humans one of their greatest scientific achievements. Cry woe, destruction, ruin, and decay. The worst is death, and death will have his day.
What a truly glorious day this is. This marks the fulfillment of my most cherished dream. I have delivered a great honor to my family name, and I have justified my father's faith in me. From this day forth, I will proudly bear the mark of this school and its teachings. After the ceremony, the other students received their assigned commands. At first, there seemed to be a mistake, for mine was withheld. Then I received private word from the general, instructing me to meet him in the graduation hall that evening.
Torlek, it is good that you came.
General, I am puzzled by these circumstances.
You mean the late hour of this meeting, and the fact that you have not received your assigned command. You will understand. Once our guest arrives, wait. Here he is now.
Chang? I requested we meet in private.
Torlek has been instrumental in our efforts to thwart Melkor. He has proven himself worthy.
Very well, then. I'm here to inform you Chancellor Lorak died not 3 hours past.
And Melkor?
This whelp is not seeking the chancellorship as we had presumed. He publicly declared himself emperor of the Klingon people no more than an hour ago.
This is preposterous. There has not been a functioning emperor since the time of Krok the Weak. The fool's brother had more sense.
Not so. This is a very unusual yet calculated move. Melkor is leveraging his family's influence with outrageous promises of glory. It is certain I will be named Lorak's successor. I will need you to gather your fleet.
No!
What?
I cannot support you in this, Gorkon.
Are you mad? Have you also fallen under this Melkor's spell?
Do not insult me if you have any doubts as to my feelings for Melkor. Ask his dead brother.
Then be reasonable.
I have never been otherwise. Gorkon, we've been friends for a long time now. We both know that if you become Chancellor, you will seek a peace with the Federation. I cannot abide this. I will fight the House of Geok, but I cannot in good conscience support you.
Your conscience did not prevent you from killing Melkor's brother.
When I killed Kalnor, Lorak was still very much alive.
You say this knowing the threat Melkor poses.
Better that fate than a future where we become Federation slaves.
And this is your final answer?
It is.
So be it then. You were always a stubborn fool, Chang, but this time your hatred will cost us everything.
As of today, we are at war.
Torlek! I trust you have settled your affairs?
Yes, sir, I have.
Good. Then listen carefully. Hostilities have already begun. All sides are vying for the allegiance of the best commanders available to them. And with your arrival, I now have everyone I need. Our resources, however, are a different matter. They are scattered throughout the length of the Empire. Several freighter commanders loyal to me have undergone considerable risk to gather a portion of these resources. You must ensure their safe passage. I am assigning you command of an insurrection-class destroyer. This command will be the first. That's truly yours. I have every confidence you will conduct yourself in the proper manner. Now, go.
Torlek! You bloodless son of a Targ!
Better a Targ forefather than your human one.
I should have known if the general refused me a squadron, he would at least have the wisdom to let me serve under you.
I am glad we will fight our first real battles together, my friend. With everything developing so quickly, I was uncertain when that would be.
Well, now that we are together again, it will be but a few days before we slaughter this Melkor and all of his fleets. Just think of the glory that will soon be ours!
One thing at a time, Zharchek. For now, form up on my wing and follow me to the Korok system.
Acknowledged.
Fellow warriors, the war has begun. There will be no more courting of allegiances and no more uncertainties. Do not underestimate the task before us. Our enemy is formidable. The House of Geoch enjoys vast resources. And of the three factions in this conflict, ours is the smallest. Yet while we are few, we are the best in the Empire. And we are enough. I give you my solemn pledge, if each of you fulfills your duty honorably, we will annihilate the enemy. And by the time we have defeated them, blood and destruction shall be so in use and dreadful objects so familiar that mothers shall but smile when they behold their infants quartered with the hands of war. We begin our operations within the hour. Kapla!
Torlek, do not attempt to flee. I have placed a transmitter aboard your vessel that allows us to track you.
What is this, Zharchek?
I have decided to defect. I am joining Melkor's side.
Why?
Our empire could regain its greatness. All it takes is vision. Our esteemed general would rather sit in his academy, quote his human poet, and contemplate his obsession with the Federation. Melkor's side is the only one that makes any sense. Why should we wait for Chang to throw us scraps when we could achieve true greatness? Melkor has promised me my own squadron and ample opportunity for glory. He would make this same offer to you. Join me, Torlek. Think of what we could accomplish together.
You want me to ally myself with Melkor? Betray General Chang?
Why not? He has already betrayed us. He betrays our true potential every time he sends us on these degrading missions. He has humiliated us from our first day at the Academy.
I cannot join you, Zharchek. I care nothing for glory if it means betraying my honor.
Then keep your precious virtue intact. Your death will mark the first victory I deliver to Lord Melkor.
This goes against everything we've been taught, Zharchek.
What difference does that make? Chang believes in these virtues more than we do, and he will still fail in the end. We both entered the Academy because we will be given our own commands that much sooner. Why should we let the beliefs of an old fool stop us from achieving what we were born to do?
How can you be so certain Melkor will honor his promises?
My friend, I would not have put us both in this situation unless I was certain of its outcome.
Very well. I trust you. But understand, I do not choose this lightly.
This marks a great day in history, Torlek. Years from now, they will say this was the beginning of a partnership that led to the conquest of the galaxy. You will see. You've done the right thing, my friend.
Are you insane? Did you graduate from the same academy I did? How can you betray everything you've been taught? Your honor!
Save your breath! If I wanted lectures, I would still be with Chang. Truly, have you not tired of his endless speeches yet? If he were half the warrior that he is a speaker, he would have already defeated Melkor and Gorka combined with no help from any of our fleets.
It shames me that I even know you, much less called you friend. You think you betrayed General Chang. Well, know this. Your betrayal to me is far worse. Turn about and face me, Khadiba!
Torlek, I have given you a chance at greatness. I could have just delivered your corpse to Melkor.
I said turn about and face me! Must I broadcast your cowardice to your new comrades?
Very well, then. I will meet your challenge. You want to follow Chang? Let him lead you to a worthless death!
Torlek, the general has ordered me to escort you back to the fleet. You are to stand down as commander of the Kemwihek and surrender yourself into my custody.
I am in no mood for games, Kaporek. I just nearly lost my ship and crew to that worthless traitor, Zhazhak.
The general knows of Zhazhak's treason. He intends to question you regarding the incident and of the role you played in it. If you will not cooperate, then my orders are to destroy you.
What? Does the general believe I am also a traitor?
That is not for me to say. I am simply following orders. Torlek, I don't believe you to be a traitor. But haven't I warned you in the past? I never trusted Zhazhak, and you should have listened to me. Now look at the situation he's gotten you into.
Very well. I will cooperate with you. I will prove to the general that I am no traitor.
With this captured starbase, we have achieved a turning point in the war. Melkor has sought to avoid a personal confrontation with our forces, but now he has little choice. This starbase will serve as a springboard to the most important holdings of the House of Geok. When we have pierced his vitals, the enemy will have no choice but to face us. Then at a time of my choosing, I will put an end to this dishonorable traitor. With his defeat, I will be able to block the impending ascension of Chief of Staff Gorkon. Both threats will be countered and eliminated. The honor of it does pay the act of it. I urge you. Haluk!
Sir.
What's happened?
Reactors have been sabotaged. We are losing power. Containment field will collapse in 18 minutes.
This starbase has been sabotaged. We have 18 minutes before auxiliary power is lost and the antimatter containment field collapses. Beam back to your warships now. We must save as many warriors and resources as possible. Once aboard your ships, fill your holds with evacuees and tow a captured warship away from the blast area. You have 17 minutes! Move!
Melkor, no more sabotage. No more shameful acts of sabotage. You hear me? Break off from your fleet. I will do the same. And we'll settle this, you and I.
Sir, Melkor is hailing General Chang on an open channel.
Merge the two transmissions.
Chang? Is this how you would pay homage to your future emperor?
You're a coward. Come about and face me. Let's see how well you fight when you have no shadows in which to hide.
You mistake me for my dead brother, Chang. I am not of woman born. Isn't that what your human poet would say? I have no need to fight. You are already defeated. Your forces are in disarray, weighed down by refugees. Resistance is suicide. But I can be generous. Bow down before me, Chang, and you may participate in my victory over Gorkon. As a sign of my good faith, I swear to you I will never allow peace with the Federation.
You think you can seduce me with false promises while you cower from my challenge? Very well, then I will come to you. Even if I must cut down every warrior you hide behind. Torlek.
General, if you mean to kill Melkor, I will follow you and provide fire support.
Now there is no time. Even if I managed to kill this coward by sacrificing myself, our fleet would never reach safety. Not with the refugees they carry, and not as outnumbered as we are. Release the vessel you are towing and attack the forward elements of Melkor's fleet. I will pursue Melkor, but will dispatch a strike group to assist you. You must slow Melkor's advance until you are recalled. We must regroup, and you must buy us the time to do so. Melkor believes I come for him. In his cowardice, he has kept the heaviest warships in his fleet to protect himself. This is our only hope. Chang, out.
Chang, allied vessel, what is the meaning of this?
Sir, I am under orders to capture this mobile repair facility.
I remind you, we fight the same enemy. I do not wish a confrontation with Chang, but I have no intention of allowing you to seize this facility.
Then you will lose far more. I will destroy any warship that interferes with my orders.
You will die in the attempt. It is a pity Chang's standards have fallen so far. In the past, he would never allow such fools to serve him.
You make a valid point, sir. I will not interfere in your operations any further. Mavon Boom, out! Nor do I wish a confrontation, sir. But my orders are clear. I will capture this repair dock or die in the attempt.
You were with Chang when I last met him. Torlek, is it not?
Yes, sir. I now serve General Chang as one of his senior captains.
It has been some time since I last spoke with him. I've made several attempts at contact, but they have all been ignored. I may be willing to negotiate for the repair dock if you can arrange a meeting with the General.
I am not here to negotiate with you, sir. If you will not release the repair facility, then we have nothing further to discuss.
You leave me with no choice, Captain.
I do not have the authority to establish any meetings, sir. I must confer with my superiors. Until a decision is reached, I will leave this system in peace. Mavon Boom, out! I am not empowered to broker any meetings, sir. My orders are exact. But there may be another way.
I am listening.
We are starved for repair facilities. If you freely release it to me, it would serve as a gesture of peace. Enough, perhaps, for the General to see the time has come to reconcile his differences with you. We fight the same enemy, do we not?
And if I refuse?
Then I will feast in the halls of Stovakor this day, together with the warriors you have sent to stop me.
I see your mentor's sense for choosing warriors is still quite keen. Very well, Captain Torlek. I am aware of Chang's need for war material. I will agree to your suggestion, but on one condition only.
Sir?
I grant this as a sign of my good faith. Remind the General we fight the same enemy. The day will come when he must deal with me if we are to save the Empire. Gorkon out.
My fellow warriors, we have captured a Romulan diplomat in Klingon space. Under interrogation, he has revealed the full extent of Melkor's involvement with the Romulan Empire. It seems that, in exchange for military support, Melkor has promised the Talinor gate system to the Romulans. This traitor, this usurper has thrown away our principal source of energy production. Word of this is spreading throughout the Empire, even as I speak. Melkor's political support will evaporate, for that will not be enough. We must warp immediately to the Talinor gates and capture the entire system. This attack will surely draw Melkor out into the open and the trap will be closed. By day's end, the war will be over. That'll be all. Kapla.
Kamak? On screen!
Kalos's beard. Torlek. I meant only to hail the nearest of Chang's warships. But it is fitting I have found you.
Kamak, how can you, of all warriors, serve this honorless traitor?
But that is a sad tale. Suffice to say that my elder brother, head of my house, threw in his lot with Melkor. I had no choice but to follow. I have hailed you to deliver this urgent warning. this system and everything in it will be completely destroyed.
What do you mean? How?
There is a device aboard my ship, stolen months ago from a research center, that is designed to attenuate large gravitational fields. I intend to activate it at the edge of the black hole's event horizon. The gravimetric waves will radically destabilize the Talinor sun, forcing it to become a supernova.
Why? What will this accomplish?
Melkor would rather see the Talinor gates utterly destroyed than lose it to Chang. I have been ordered to be the instrument of his spite, Torlik.
That is insane. This star system is the Empire's chief source of energy production. Think what this will mean to our people. Melkor will lose this battle regardless, but your actions will cripple the Empire.
I know this. Yet my duty requires it. But my honor demands that I deliver this warning. Leave the system now. You have just enough time to warn your comrades and warp out before the cataclysm.
Listen to me, Kamak. You must not do this.
Glory and honor to you, Torlik, son of Robah. Tell the general. Tell him I regret he will never find me in the halls of Stovokor.
Kamak! Wait!
Fellow warriors, despite our recent loss, I wish to commend you for your actions in the Talinor system. No one could foresee the full extent of Melkor's treachery. With the destruction of the Talinor system, we have forever lost a part of our birthright. As a result, the usurper now stands alone. No one in the Empire will support Melkor, and the entire House of Geok faces certain discommendation. The war against the usurper is over, yet our duty is not concluded. We must find Melkor and deliver him before the High Council to face punishment for treason. This is our only chance, however slight, of stopping Gorkon's ascension. Time is of the essence. You will each be assigned a search pattern to fulfill. That'll be all. Chang out.
Chang, allied vessel, I wish to parley with you under a flag of truce.
This is Captain Torlek of the dreadnought Molidad.
Yes, Captain Torlek. I trust General Chang has made good use of the repair facility I lent him?
Yes, sir, he has. But I suspect you did not contact me simply to ask me this.
Now that the war has ended, the High Council will reconvene to recognize me as Chancellor. After this, I will have no choice but to view Chang's continuous actions as treasonous. I wish to avoid this outcome, Captain. Under the rights of Rojhome, I will await Chang in the Lokdar system for 2 days with my escort group. I pledge my word I will make every effort to reach an acceptable compromise. Carry this message back to your mentor, Captain. It is time we mended our empire.
On screen.
Chang, allied vessel, I wish to parley with you under a flag of truce.
This is Captain Torlek of the dreadnought Molidad.
Captain, I understand you have become one of Chang's most favored commanders. That is good, for there is something you must do.
And what would that be?
Now that the war has ended, the High Council will reconvene to recognize me as Chancellor. After this, I will have no choice but to view Chang's continuous actions as treasonous. I wish to avoid this outcome, Captain. Under the rights of Rojhome, I will await Chang in the Lokdar system for 2 days with my escort group. I pledge my word I will make every effort to reach an acceptable compromise. Carry this message back to your mentor, Captain. It is time we mended our empire. Chang, allied vessel, I wish to parley with you under a flag of truce.
This is Captain Torlek of the dreadnought Molidad.
Captain Torlek, I understand you are one of Chang's most favored commanders. Your reputation has traveled far in a short span of time.
Much has happened since the war began, sir. What is it you would ask of me?
Now that the war has ended, the High Council will reconvene to recognize me as Chancellor. After this, I will have no choice but to view Chang's continuous actions as treasonous. I wish to avoid this outcome, Captain. Under the rights of Roj Home, I will await Chang in the Lockdar system for 2 days with my escort group. I pledge my word I will make every effort to reach an acceptable compromise. Carry this message back to your mentor, Captain. It is time we mended our empire.
I understand, sir. I will deliver your message to the General.
Good. If the rest of Chang's warriors are as wise as you have demonstrated, Captain, I have no doubt he will receive the very best counsel in this matter. Gorkon out.
I am a warship captain, not a courier. If you have something to say to the General, say it to his face.
There's been enough strain between Chang and I. I should not have to debate with his minions. Do you wish to see him branded a traitor?
Very well. I will tell the General what you have said. But I suspect he would just as soon talk peace with the Federation as he would with you.
I shall remember how difficult it was to gain your cooperation, Captain. Gorkon out.
Torlak, I have much to discuss with you.
General, I recently encountered Gorkon in the Kovault system. He asked that I deliver an urgent message to you concerning the war.
That is unimportant now. I have just received a coded transmission from the usurper.
Melkor? You have his location?
No, but I know where he plans to be. He is claiming the right of vengeance for the death of his brother and has challenged me to battle in the Talinor system. I have decided to accept.
Sir, this could only be a trap.
Possibly, but that makes no difference.
I do not understand, sir. If this is a trap, why would
If I capture Melkor or kill him, I will achieve the objective we have sought since the destruction of the Talinor gates. Even if it is a trap and I fail, I will die an honorable death against a hated enemy. Either is preferable to seeing Gorkon's dreams come to fruition. And this is the only alternative left to me. I must do this.
Yes, General, but why now? Can we not wait long enough to gather the fleet? So if there is a trap,
There is no time. The duel will take place in 3 hours. It will require a full day to recall the fleet from their search.
Then allow me to accompany you, sir.
No. The fleet must be recalled, and your place is here to await them.
But Gorkon said
I know what message Gorkon asked you to bring me. It is the same one he has sent numerous times before, and I must still decline. My only condition for reconciliation is his solemn oath he will never seek peace with the Federation, and this oath he will never give.
Then this is the only way.
It is. Torlak, if I do not return, I expect you will conduct yourself in a manner befitting everything I have taught you. In my absence, you will command the fleet. Kapla.
Kapla!
Captain, all our rebels are getting ahead. Swarm for the city. Repeat, is the General Chang your horse?
Calm! Lock down that signal. General, this is Captain Torlak. Your signal is faint, but we are receiving you.
Torlak, there's little time. Listen to me carefully. Melkor did set a trap. He still enjoys the support of the Romulans, and in numbers far surpassing anything previously seen. They hit us as soon as we arrived in system.
How can that be? He was finished!
He's not finished. After he destroyed the Talinor gates, he went straight to the Romulan Senate and persuaded them to support his bid for the Emperor's throne. This Melkor even had the temerity to boast of his treason while we battle for our lives.
General, I can be at your present location in less than an hour.
Torlak, this war has left the Empire in the weakest condition it has known for over a century. We must end this now, before Melkor and his Romulan allies attack in full force. I order you to locate as many warships as you can and bring them to the Talinor system at maximum warp. You must find Melkor and kill him, no matter what the cost.
General, give us your coordinates. We will regroup with you first, then hunt down the traitor.
Forget about me! My only hope is to hold Melkor here long enough for you to make a kill. We must make every sacrifice to save our empire. This is what we've been praying for! This is what it means to be Klingon.
We meet again, Captain Torlak.
Gorkon, there is little time. General Chang is trapped in the Talinor Nebula battling Melkor. He is surrounded by a task force of Romulan warships.
The usurper? Romulans? What does...
Melkor has enlisted the full support of the Romulan Empire. He is renewing his bid for the throne. I am ordered to locate any available warships and bring them to the Talinor Nebula at maximum warp. If we are to stop Melkor, we must do so now before he can escape us again.
If what you say is true, there is no time to waste. My escorts and I will proceed immediately to the Talinor Nebula. Gorkon out. We meet again, Captain Torlek.
Gorkon, there is little time. General Chang is trapped in the Talinor Nebula battling Melkor as we speak. He is currently surrounded by a task force of Romulan warships.
Usurper. Romulans?
Melkor has enlisted the full support of the Romulan Empire. He is renewing his bid for the throne. I am ordered to locate any available warships and bring them to the Talinor Nebula at maximum warp. If we are to stop Melkor, we must do so now before he can escape us again.
So, now the General needs my help, he shows no hesitation in asking for it. Very well, Captain. I will follow you to the Talinor Nebula, but understand that what you ask carries a price. Gorkon out. We meet again, Captain Torlek.
Gorkon, there is little time. General Chang is trapped in the Talinor Nebula battling Melkor. He is surrounded by a task force of Romulan warships.
Usurper? Romulans? What does...
Melkor has enlisted the full support of the Romulan Empire. He is renewing his bid for the throne. I am ordered to locate any available warships and bring them to the Talinor Nebula at maximum warp. If we are to stop Melkor, we must do so now before he can escape us again.
Very well, Captain. I will take you at your word and proceed to the Talinor Nebula. Gorkon out.
On screen.
Torlek! What have you done?
Sir?
Melkor has escaped. You have failed me and left the Empire in a state far worse than it ever was before.
General, I returned with the assistance you required.
I did not ask you to bring Gorkon! He has spared me a defeat for which I now owe him a debt of honor. I must pledge my loyalty to him and abandon all opposition to his policies.
General, I...
Be silent! It is now certain Melkor will launch a full attack, and I am forced to serve Gorkon in preparing a defense. You will play no part in this battle. From this instant, you are on border patrol. You will no longer serve in my fleet. Let this be a reminder of your failure to me.
I am Brigadier Tok. State your name and purpose for being here.
I am Captain Torlek. We are responding to the outpost distress signal. Are any Federation warships still in the area?
Ah, but this is better than we could have hoped. There are no Federation warships in the area, minion of Chang. There never were.
What? What do you mean by this?
I serve Lord Melkor, and we destroyed the observation outpost.
Why?
By now, the fake distress call should be reaching Kronos Prime. When Chang hears it, he will interpret it as being the beginning of a full-scale Federation attack. He will not hesitate to warp to this location with as many warships as he can muster. Gorkon's strength will be cut in half, and Lord Melkor shall conquer Kronos.
You have wasted the lives of warriors for nothing. The General is ordered to remain at Kronos in preparation for the forthcoming battle.
You overestimate Chang! He cannot resist this temptation. When he learns the Federation has killed his prize student, he will be in a fury to start a major conflict. Chang will serve Lord Melkor as the perfect peace offering to the Federation. Your mentor will spend the rest of his days in a Federation penal colony, where he will be denied even the most ignoble death.
Chang will never betray his duty. I will
do not waste your breath! There is a Romulan heavy task force in this sector, and they know of your presence. You cannot defeat us.
We will see Khadiba, but whatever happens, you will not live long enough to see it.
Come, close channel. Transmit an urgent message to Kronos and inform them of what has happened.
Torlek, we received your transmission too late. Chang departed as soon as he learned of the distress signal. He has taken 3 assault fleets with him. This has happened at the worst possible moment.
There's a massive armada of Romulan warships crossing the neutral zone. Without Chang and his fleets, we are completely vulnerable.
Chancellor, what are your orders?
Find Chang. I know he no longer trusts you. There is little time and no one else. Tell him I am ordering his immediate return. Tell him anything, but make certain he returns.
I will do everything within my power, Chancellor.
The fate of the Empire rests with you, Torlak. You'll come out.
Torlak, I have just returned from the Valik system.
I don't have time for this, Kaporak. There is an emergency.
Listen to me! Our sensors detected three large fleets moving at high warp to the Gamma Seti system. We positively identified four of those ships, including General Chang's battleship.
Are you certain of this?
Yes. I also intercepted part of the emergency transmission sent to you by the Chancellor. It was garbled due to the long range, but I think I understand what is happening.
Thank you, Kaporak. You've given me exactly the information I need. Torlak,
wait!
Out!
Don't you...
Torlak, I am pleased that you have decided to join us on this glorious day. Let us set aside our differences and unite against the Federation.
That is not why I am here.
Oh? Then why have you come?
General, I must inform you that a large Romulan armada is en route to the Kronal system even as we speak. This is Melkor's anticipated attack. Chancellor Gorkon has ordered your immediate return.
Our enemy is here! What does the fool think I should do? Sit idly by while the Federation horde pours across our borders?
General, the Chancellor's orders are explicit. There is little time before the attack begins, and we cannot disobey the Chancellor's orders.
So this is what it has come to. You have sold yourself to Gorkon so that you may participate in the battle against Melkor. Well, do as you wish, but do not interfere with my operations, or I shall blow you out of the stars.
Sir, the destruction of the observation outpost was a deception created by Melkor. It was intended to mislead you, to divert you from the defense of Kronos. There has been no attack by the Federation, and we are not at war with them. Gorkon sent me here to inform you of this.
That is a preposterous lie. Gorkon fears a war with the Federation so much that he hides from the truth. You may share in this delusion, but I will not.
I have tried my best to reason with you, General. But you will not listen to me, and you will not follow orders. You leave me no choice but to kill you and seize command of the fleets myself.
Challenge me. Get out of my sight, Torlak! Go back to Kronos or Gretor for all I care, but do not force me to destroy you.
I cannot, General. I may die, but my duty demands I stop this insanity.
So be it. You choose to follow Gorkon? I will show you where he would lead you.
General, none of this is ultimately important. Not my arguments, not the Federation, or even Melkor. What is important is that the man we have sworn obedience to summons us home to defend our people. All that matters this day is our honor and our duty. Pursue your own war with the Federation. Kill me if you wish. But first, look me in the face and tell me you will betray everything you believe in. Admit you will betray everything you have taught me. Then I will know the Federation has already subverted you through your own hatred.
I see you have learned from me all too perfectly. Very well. I will lead the fleets back to Kronos. But understand, this is now twice I have been deprived of a worthy death in battle. I cannot possibly imagine what this will cost.
In the days that followed the end of the Civil War, much changed. Chancellor Gorkon wasted little time solidifying his position. Under his leadership, the Empire began forging order from the fires of chaos. But only so much can be done now that we have lost the Talanor system. Where once we were rich in resources, today we must ravage the Proxis Moon to feed our Empire's endless hunger for energy. And it came as no surprise that our tenuous alliance with the Romulans was irrevocably broken, leaving us in a state of blood feud. For this, if nothing else, the entire House of Jiho
suffered discommendation by the High Council. Those few of Melkor's supporters left alive after the reprisals sought refuge with the Romulan allies. But I believe it is better to die at the hands of an enemy than to live with such shame. And as for myself, fate decided that my glory would be a silent one. The full extent of my actions during the war was kept secret by the High Council. This was done to help preserve the story given to the Federation. I do not know if Starfleet truly believes that Chang led his fleets across the neutral zone simply to make Melkor think Kronos was left undefended. But perhaps the truth is harder to accept than the lie. Despite the convenient deception, for a brief time, rumors of my future abounded. It was said I was to be the next military advisor, a tremendous honor to me and my family name. Sadly, these rumors proved untrue. Instead, I was chosen to lead a deep space expedition in the hopes of locating new sources of energy for the Empire. And shortly before my departure, Chang asked to speak with me one last time.
Torek!
Chang. Or should I call you by your new title, Chief of Staff?
I did not ask you to meet me here in order to observe formalities.
Why? Why this meeting?
To bid you, among many other things, farewell.
Farewell? Given your animosity for me, that is the last thing I would expect you to say. Why did you agree to be Gorkon's chief of staff? Your debt of honor to him has been repaid in full.
Oh, no, it has not. Gorkon insisted I serve the next 2 years in this capacity. How did he put it to me? Ah, yes. Despite our differences, there is none more qualified, and no one else I can trust to keep me honest. Those were his words. Artfully diplomatic, wouldn't you say?
General Chang, I know that you blocked my nomination to be the next military advisor. So why this friendly farewell? We both know you still harbor a grudge for my actions at the Tali Nor Nebula.
Now, time has made me realize that you were simply doing what I had taught you to do, Torek. You conducted yourself as a true warrior, and you did so superbly. I bear you no grudge. It would be best, however, if you left the Empire for some time. We stand at the brink of a difficult new future. This future will discard its old heroes and raise new ones. You are the finest student I have ever taught. And you must claim your proper place in this future, while I must step aside. In the past, you served me as a loyal warrior, a friend, and my conscience when things were at their worst. But where I go now, you cannot follow, and I will need no conscience but my own. Farewell, Torek, son of Roebuck.
Conscience? What have you resigned yourself to, Chang?
Some rise by sin and some by virtue fall.
What do you mean by all this? Where are you going?
I go to the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveler returns.
That was the last day I ever saw General Chang. And despite what came afterwards, I have never forgotten what he taught me. Today, when I am asked what became of him, I gladly sit upon the ground and tell sad tales of the death of kings.
Fight!
fellow warriors, we come together on an auspicious day to look to our new future as well as to remember. The forces of the usurper have been defeated and their threat to our empire is ended. Though many of our finest warriors fell honorably in battle, their glorious death is tinged with remorse. For they cannot stand proudly with us as we forge a new destiny for our empire. In remembrance of them, our honored dead, who died in this, our greatest challenge, we now dedicate this monument. Let this forever be a reminder of their sacrifice. Fellow warriors, we are here today to honor the memory of our fallen dead. The forces of the usurper have been defeated, and their threat to our empire is ended. Though many of our finest warriors fell in this great conflict, none sacrificed more than those members of the last graduating class of the Elite Command Academy. Their shining example shall serve as a testimony of what it means to be a warrior for generations to come. In remembrance of them, we now dedicate this monument. Let it stand as a reminder of their service, and let us raise our voices in praise of their memory until the sound rattles the very walls of Kinlot. Fellow warriors, we gather upon this auspicious day to honor the memory of our fallen dead. The usurper has been defeated. His threat to our empire is ended. And though many have fallen to achieve this, no one has sacrificed or accomplished more than Torlek, son of Rovach. Through triumph and treachery, his service to the empire was unswerving. His valorous conduct exemplified those virtues we all strive to perfect. It is in remembrance of him that we now dedicate this monument. Let his memory serve as an inspiration to all those who hear the warrior's call. My fellow warriors, I have summoned you upon this extraordinary day to honor the memory of one to whom we are completely indebted. The usurper is dead. His threat to our empire forever silenced. Yet it is to Torlek, son of Rovach, that we owe this victory. No other warrior will ever reach the height of his accomplishments or plumb the depths of his sacrifice. And though he now feasts with Kalus in the halls of Stovo Kor, it is my belief that somehow he knows the full extent of our gratitude, our praise, and our admiration.
failed. I must spend what is left of my life trapped in this honorless existence on Rurupinte. I have no hope but that death will one day release my dishonored soul.